This morning, Ukraine's president has formally applied to join the EU.
Over the phone, the Ukrainian president asked to fast-track EU membership.
State candidacy status.
We appeal to the European Union for Ukraine's immediate accession under a new special procedure. Our goal is to be with all Europeans now.
They belong to us, they are one of us, and we want them in.
The first direct peace talks being held between Ukraine and Russia.
Well, they went on for hours.
The main goal was a ceasefire and halt to hostilities.
As predicted, they don't seem to have come up with any firm conclusion.
Ending the meeting with a promise to hold a second round.
As the talks were going on, there were reports of increased shelling.
Bombardment of the capital, bombardment of Kharkiv, and also the assaults on the southern flanks.
We've been targeted from east, north, west, and south.
Russia has fired more than 350 missiles, some of them hitting civilian homes.
The small heart getting CPR belongs to a six-year-old girl in Mariupol.
Show this to Putin, the eyes of this child, and crying doctors.
They used the vacuum bomb today, which is actually prohibited by Geneva Convention.
People continue to die.
On the ground, Ukrainian forces are continuing to put up stiff resistance.
There has been a ferocious battle here on the outskirts of Kiev. There's a body there. That's a Russian soldier. But he's lying there dead on this bridge.
What's actually happening is that they are fighting back, perhaps with more resistance than the Kremlin had bargained for.
Each of us is a warrior.
Supplies are dwindling as Russian forces surround the city, forcing residents to queue for hours to get basic supplies.
The U.S. Treasury Department announcing new sanctions.
Sanctions against Russia's central bank, immobilizing any of its assets here in the United States.
The ruble has plunged and the central bank has more than doubled its official interest rate.
FIFA, the world governing body of football, and also UEFA, they are suspending all Russian teams.
The UN estimates that more than 500,000 people have already fled Ukraine.
My husband says you need to leave.
The United Nations General Assembly is holding an emergency meeting on Ukraine.
We have credible accounts of residential buildings, critical civilian infrastructure, and other non-military targets sustaining heavy damage. Enough is enough.
Because I would like to read from the screenshot of the smartphone of a killed Russian soldier.
Mama, I'm in Ukraine. I'm afraid. We are bombing all of the cities, even targeting civilians. We were told that they would welcome us, and they are falling under our armored vehicles, throwing themselves under the wheels and not allowing us to pass. They call us fascists. Mama, this is so hard. And this was several moments before he was killed.
Poor little six-year-old in there, you know, all these innocent children caught up in this. I saw on the weekend, I don't know if you saw the vision of a little NICU unit, a hospital that had been targeted. So they had to move a NICU unit with all these tiny babies on life support into the street. You know, there was a picture I saw online today of all these children and babies huddled in a shelter, you know, unaware, I'm assuming, to what's going on around them. I know many of the 7.5 million children have left because they've gone with their mums while their dads have stayed behind fighting. But, you know, you just see that there, just that innocence all in a room while,
the human face. Oh. The human face of something that no one seemingly wants except for one person that we know.
I know.
And the helplessness is just debilitating, except for the Ukrainians who are just so...
defiant.
Yes.
I know.
Yes.
Incredible.